So hello everyone and a very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. In this session guys, as usually I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group here. You will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and iska link you can find in the description. You can also follow me here also you can ask anything related to examinations. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, as per the recent bulletin of Registrar General of India, what is the infant mortality rate at national level in the year 2019? So humne pichle session mein bhi MMR ke bare mein padha tha. In this session we'll talk about IMR, which is infant mortality rate, and life expectancy. Now you have to tell me in the comment section that what is the meaning of infant mortality rate. I have told you so many times before this, infant mortality rate kya hota hai, please write down in the comments. So let's talk about the news then. As per the recent bulletin of Registrar General of India, IMR, jo current IMR hai hamara, that is infant mortality rate, is 30 per 1000 live birth. Theek hai, and this the reference year is 2019. Okay, so what is the IMR in the year 2019? 30 per 1000 live births. And what is the life expectancy, by the way? It is 69.4 years during the period of 2014 to 18. 4 saal ke period mein the life expectancy is 69.4 years. All right so isme itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada detail mein jaane ki you don't have to go into the details of this particular news. That is not required for the exam. Okay, so now let's come back to the question. The question is regarding infant mortality rate. So that is 30 per 1000 live births. Option E will be the correct answer. Okay, option E, according to this bulletin, 30 per 1000 live birth is the current IMR as of 2019. All right and now let's move ahead to question number 2. It is based on a scheme. Consider the following statements with respect to Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Rozgar Abhiyan, and you have to identify the correct statement. And guys, as you all know, the parliamentary session is going on right now, so there are a lot of news from the existing schemes only. ठीक है, जैसे कि ये existing scheme है, इसके ऊपर एक reply submit हुआ parliament में, so we have to discuss this scheme. Alright, and इसमें मैं वो सारी schemes discuss नहीं करूँगा जो already बहुत बार हो चुकी हैं. जैसे for example प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना, आई हैव डिस्कस सो मेनी टाइम. प्रधानमंत्री ग्रामीण सड़क योजना, आई हैव डिस्कस इट सो मेनी टाइम. एमजी नरेगा, सो मेनी टाइम्स इट हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड. सो आई विल नॉट टेक दो स्कीम्स, आई विल टेक ओनली दो स्कीम्स जिनका डिस्कशन उतना ज्यादा हमने नहीं किया है. ऑलराइट, सो वन ऑफ दो स्कीम इज प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण रोजगार अभियान, एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस स्कीम. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस स्कीम. सो अगेन इट इज द न्यूज बिकॉज अ रिप्लाई वॉज सबमिटेड इन पार्लियामेंट रिगार्डिंग दी successful implementation of this scheme. Okay, and that's why we are discussing it. So what is the objective? First of all, what is the objective? It is Garib Kalyan Rozgar Abhiyan, which means it is a scheme which caters to employment, which caters to the employment of poor people. Okay, Garib means what? Poor. Kalyan means welfare, and Rozgar means what? Employment. So under this scheme the government intends to provide employment to the poor of the country. Now what type of poor are these? So basically, remember, this scheme was launched in the year 2020 during the lockdown, when so many people migrated from their place of work to their place of origin. Ya apne kaam ki jagah se wo apne gaon wagaira chale gaye the. Theek hai, so jab wo gaon gaye, wapas gaye, when they migrated to their origin cities, then unke paas jo kaam tha uski kami thi, there was no employment. So that's why this scheme was launched, to provide employment to those migrants. All right so to boost employment and livelihood opportunities for migrant workers returning to villages and similarly affected citizens in the rural areas. So this scheme caters only to the rural areas. All right because of course there is a lack of opportunity of employment in the rural areas only. Urban areas mein kafi zyada employment hai hamare desh mein. Theek hai, it's just ki aapke andar kitna talent hai aur aap kaise usko acquire kar sakte ho. All right launch year, it was launched in the year 2020 with a total expected outlay of rupees 50,000 crore. This was the expected outlay. Theek hai, 50,000 crore hum kharch karenge. And the focus areas, 116 selected districts were selected, jiske upar focus kiya jayega, and these 116 districts are from 6 states. 6 states ke ye 116 districts hain, which are these 6 states: Bihar, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh. So these are the 6 states on which this scheme is focused on. All right. Now इस reply में थोड़ा सा achievement के बारे में बताया गया है. So it has achieved employment generation of 50.78 crore percentage with a total expenditure of approximately 40,000 crore. This data is not important for your examination. This is just for the basic understanding that in that reply क्या क्या चीजें लिखी हुई थी. So basically that reply is about was about the achievement of this particular scheme. Okay, the important part for us for our examination is the scheme only. All right. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify correct statement. It was launched in 2021. No, it was launched in 2020. The total outlay was rupees 20,000 crore. No, not 20,000 crore. It was 50,000 crores, and it is focused on 116 selected districts across 7 states. 116 districts are there, but they are not across 7 states. They are across 6 states. So this statement is also incorrect, which means none is correct should be the correct answer, option D. Option D, none is correct. And guys, remember in today's session, we are going to discuss five questions. And all the five questions are very, very important. Pehla question bhi aapne dekha, that was very important. This question is also very important. And the next three questions are also very, very important. Theek hai? Chote chote questions hai. उन सभी क्वेश्चंस को हमने ज्यादा डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं है, बट वो छोटे क्वेश्चंस बहुत बड़े यूजफुल होंगे आपके एग्जाम में. ऑलराइट, मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. एज पर नेशनल रेल प्लान विजन ऑफ 2030, व्हाट इज द टारगेट परसेंटेज ऑफ मॉडल शेयर ऑफ रेलवेज इन फ्रेट. फ्रेट में रेलवे का कितना शेयर होगा एज पर दिस विजन. कितना टारगेट है फ्रेट सर्विसेज में, पूरा जितना भी फ्रेट सिस्टम है हमारा उसमें रेलवे का कितना परसेंट शेयर होगा. ठीक है, ये इसके अंडर एक टारगेट रखा गया है अंडर दिस नेशनल रेल प्लान विजन 2030. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इज इट अ न्यू विजन, क्या ये रिसेंटली लॉन्च हुआ है? नो, ये रिसेंटली लॉन्च नहीं हुआ है. इट इज इन न्यूज बिकॉज अगेन रिप्लाई वाज सबमिटेड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रेलवेज हेडेड बाय अश्विनी वैष्णव रिगार्डिंग दिस नेशनल रेल प्लान विजन 2030. एंड देर आर फोर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स इन दिस प्लान विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. नंबर 1, टू फॉर्मुलेट स्ट्रैटेजीज based on both operational capacities and commercial policy initiatives to increase the percentage sharing of railways in freight to 45%. Kitna karna chahte hain? 45% karna chahte hain under this vision. All right. Number 2, reducing transit time of freight by increasing the average speed of freight trains to 50 km per hour. Aapne dekha hoga malgaadi ko kahin pe bhi rok diya jata hai kisi bhi jagah pe. So this plan intends to increase the average speed of freight trains by 50 km per hour, 250 km per hour. 100% electrification is also one of the targets under this vision. And high speed railway corridors and dedicated freight corridors will also be identified and uske upar kaam kiya jayega under this particular vision. Now this vision document has a lot of things, but those are not important for us. These are the only four most important points which are important for our examination. Theek hai, isse zyada detail mein padhne ki there is no need. So now let's come back to the question. The question is regarding percentage in the freight. So that is 45%. Option D is the correct answer. All right. I hope this question is clear. And as I told you already, there is no need to go into the details. You don't have to do PhD in these topics. Okay. That is not the requirement. Okay. Hamara jo concern hai, that is just to clear the examination. And hum utna hi padhenge jitne mein hamara exam nikal jayega. Okay. Extra padhne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. बिकॉज हम जानते हैं कि सिलेबस की कोई लिमिटेशन नहीं है. करंट अफेयर जितना पढ़ते चले जाओगे, जीए को जितना मर्जी पढ़ते चले जाओगे, वो उतना कम है. राइट, सो यू हैव टू बी यू नो आपको स्पेसिफिक होना पड़ेगा इन योर प्रिपरेशन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज यूनिफाइड लॉजिस्टिक इंटरफेस प्लेटफॉर्म विच इन शॉर्ट इज यूलिप इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर डेटा एक्सचेंज अमंग ऑल मोड ऑफ ऑपरेटर्स इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सेक्टर. रिमेंबर दिस इज अगेन नॉट अ न्यू पोर्टल, दिस इज नॉट अ न्यू प्लेटफॉर्म, दिस इज ऑलरेडी इन एक्जिस्टेंस. We are discussing about it because it is in news, because again a reply was submitted in parliament. Which of the following organizations has designed the platform under the guidance of Niti Aayog? Kaun se organization ne is platform ko design kiya hai? Now the objective of this platform, ye kyun banaya gaya tha, ye already question mein mention hai. It is a platform for data exchange among all mode of operators in transportation sector. Transportation sector mein jitne bhi mode of operations hote hain, like एयरलाइन हो गए, रेलवेज हो गए, रोड हो गया, शिप हो गया, इन सभी के ऑपरेटर्स एक जगह पे कंबाइन होकर अपने डेटा को एक्सचेंज कर सके. दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस प्लेटफॉर्म एंड इट वॉज डिजाइन बाय नेशनल इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन लिमिटेड अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ नीति आयोग. ऑलराइट, सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. आई होप दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर. And the last question for today, to provide credit at affordable rates to boost food processing sector, a special fund is missing here. A special fund had been created in NABARD. What is the corpus of the fund? Corpus kya hai us fund ka, jo ki NABARD ke under create kiya gaya tha to boost the food processing industry sector. All right. So this is option A, rupees 2000 crore. And again, this is not a new fund. It is in news. Because of discussion in the parliament. So option A, 2000 crore is the correct answer. And this question is very, very important for the NABARD grade A aspirants. NABARD grade A aspirants ke liye bahut zyada important hai. To ye dhyan rakhiyega. In fact, sabke liye important hai. Alright, because agriculture ek aisa topic hai jo ki har exam mein pucha jata. So option A, 2000 crore is the correct answer. Now, can you tell me who is the chairperson of NABARD? Write down in the comments. And that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. And remember, all the 5 questions that we have discussed today are very, very important. Chote chote question the, par bahut bade question the. Dono hi baatein ek saath hain. Alright. So I'll see you in the next session on Monday. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care. And God bless.